it's pretty much what we've instilled in them from day one since I've been here. The mentality is more important sometimes than ability. And, you know, we've got a good mentality here. We might not have the best players, but you know, we make sure that the mentality is good and the attitude is good. And that's what we try and work on, you know, to try and achieve results. Besides having a way of playing or whatever, but I thought, look, that's what we do. So the young ones, old ones, wherever they are, it's important that they buy into the ethics of the club and the team, and that's it. That's how we operate. Woodley hasn't played. Woodley played one game, so he hasn't played. He's missed the last six or seven. So I don't know how many games he's missed. Six. There's another one he hasn't played. He won't play as well. He's injured. He's done as, what do you call this, abductor, groin, or whatever they call his muscles. So he won't play. And now we've got to get a centre-back. So I must more than likely give the under-19 centre-back another debut. We've given it three or four already. Might as well give another one. He must probably play. There was a vision sold to me at the beginning of this whole start of this campaign. And they brought me in. They wanted to win the league. They've never won the league in 99 years or 97 years when it was. We won it 2 years ago. That was the whole objective. And nobody thought it could be done because the Vits have never done it. So we did that. That's something to, you know, that can never take away from us. We won the league. A club of our size to win the league should never, ever happen. We did that. And we won every other trophy besides the Nedbank. We got into the final. And we lost in the final of that one. So, but we won every other trophy since, you know, our technical staff have been here. So, you know, you could say mission accomplished. But certainly the biggest accomplishment is producing young players. And we produced a few and sold a few. And I think that's... For me, that will always live with me, that, you know, moving players and giving them better opportunities to earn more money and those type of things. And, yeah, it's very sad, but it's going to come to an end next week. Congratulations to Maswaiswai. I don't know if when I was there, I don't know if the same supporters are still alive. There was such an old group of them who gave me such a bollock in every week. They used to bollock me and shout and scream at me every week. And I told them when I left there, I said, you'll miss me. And then they all laughed and joked at me. 2 years later, they got relegated. So, yeah. Let's not go there. It's a fantastic, you know, club with a rich history. So, you know, I wish them well. I'm sure they'll be a force. It's not easy. It's, you know, from the first division to the Premier League is a big, big jump. Believe you me, the quality, everything is so much better. So they're going to get a big surprise. But I'm sure they'll beef up their squad. To what's his name, Brandon Truter, the coach, fantastic. Well done. They were nowhere. When he took over, I think they were 10 points behind or something. And to win the league like that, it's fantastic. You know, odd lines to Ajax, I'm sure they'll do well. You know, in the playoffs with TTM and whoever comes 15th in our club, in our league. Come to this time of the time of the year, with three, four games to go, sometimes a point is not bad. People think they're trying to win games. And it's crazy what happens with players, coaches, clubs. The pressure is immense. And a club like Kaizer Chiefs, who haven't won the league for, I'm not sure, 5-6 years, obviously the pressure will be even more because, you know, they're a club that expects to win trophies. So I don't know. You know, it's very difficult. What you do between now and the next game is important. Very, very important. Train, overtrain, undertrain, not train. You know, because the more you sometimes... You feel like you need to do more all the time. You don't want to leave any stone unturned. And that's where, you know, things happen. So it's a very difficult time. Very difficult time. These last three, four games. But I'm sure they've got enough experience. Ernst is an experienced coach. He's got enough know-how. So let's see what happens, you know. I wish them well. This profession is a very lonely game when you don't win. When you're winning, it's fine. Everybody loves you. And when you don't win, it's, you know, when they are so close, obviously, you know, to lose a game, especially the 93rd or 4th minute, it's not easy to handle. But as I said, I think they've got enough experience to be calm. And I think the other game now is also Morocco 1-0 up. I mean, there you go. You know, whatever. I'm sure it could change. But let's see. If it doesn't change, can you imagine? You know, so from being in the doldrums, you could be still top of the league, but I'm not sure. I mean, on a personal level, sure. You don't like to see people, you know, especially the way they were, right on top of the league for a long time. But we're in a cutthroat business, a difficult, difficult business. It doesn't take anything away from the personal relationship. You know? I'll still greet, you know, I've got no problems with that. So, yeah, I wish them all well. I wish everybody well.
And someone like you, surely by now, you are also starting to think about the future. Do you at least maybe have an idea of where you might be next season?
Right now, I'm stuck. Right now, I'm stuck in this hotel. I want to break this door down very, very soon to get out of here. So there's nothing. I don't know what I'm doing. You know, obviously, I would like to keep working, but there's nothing at the moment. Nothing.